What's up, guys? Welcome to Wasted Space. Welcome back to the Rim, where hopefully Randy can be maybe a little bit more normal this episode. It'd be quite nice. So, yeah, all sorts of weird things happened last time. We'll start off by maybe making a bit of use of the stuff that trader just dropped for us. This hasn't been worn by... reduces the impact of psychic events. Hasn't been worn by anyone weird, so I think I might get Atomic Nom to equip the Psychic Fall hat as well. Just a bunch of, like, quite nice gear. That's the problem, though. You've got to force wear them. Maybe you'll pick it up anyway if I just leave them to move everything back down to the stockpile now. I just wanted to stop some of that stuff from deteriorating, really. Do need to source our weaponry out, though. Everything's a bit weird from last time. McGow should not have the sniper rifle. He is terrible at hitting anything. So the main plan this episode, I think, is to get a bit more of a grip again. We've got to reconnect some stuff down here. Our food supply. We've got plenty of meals, but we have no actual food in stock to make any more. So that's a bit of a concern as well. I might do something about that immediately. See if there's anything around here we can harvest. Yeah, always a few bits, which is helpful. Do a bit of cougar watch while we're at it. Damn cougars. Might even get some hunting going, you know. We've got a butcher table. It's probably a good idea, especially as I notice there's a herd of gazelle over here. Who have we got on hunting? Nobody. Oh! Straight for the start of the episode. Mr. Mick, welcome aboard. What are we going to do with you? Can Hall. Oh my god. Don't need you on handling, I don't think, but construction and mining, hell yeah. And then secondary on those, that looks great. Might even be able to reduce some of the other guys at some point soon. Very nice. And someone we don't need to rename in this case, because it's Mick. Hey again, dude. How's it going? Find that very random, but kind of a cool little thing, that's sort of a byproduct of the colonies mod I'm using. So, I was doing hunting. Alucid is probably the one. Nom's out at night, so yeah, let's have Alucid do some hunting for us. And he's got a shotgun at the moment, which is not a bad option. Sorry, Gazelle, this is gonna seem a bit harsh, but yeah, kind of fair. Now, I want you to drop... Do we want the shotty? Yeah, drop the shotty. And McGow, you are hiding here. Please also drop the sniper rifle. That works. Cool. Get someone at least that's half decent at shooting things. That would be quite nice. And then, because that seems to be the main sort of issue at the moment, is the base is not very secure. And I can't really think of that many ways of improving that either. I mean, I could put ourselves a little, some bits of sandbag to help when we're trying to push out of these doors, perhaps. But it's not going to help that much in reality. Cargo pods. All right then, Randy, if you say so. What we got? Some more of that? Sure. Penoxycycline? Something like that. People did explain to me how to say it properly, and that was a while ago, and I didn't practice it, so I've forgotten already. Nice. So the limestone for these should be coming out of the wood. The stone cutting table now I've moved limestone up to the top. Okay, that's getting the research done. Mick is actually tailoring, which means we don't have any construction work down at the moment. There is the question of floors. And the fact that I still don't really know what we're going to make. It's going to have to be stone. Let's go with the sandstone for now. We got loads of that. So, I think this is pretty straightforward, to be honest. This whole area needs to be covered in. Yep. That is about it. Worry about this room afterwards. People also mentioned, and I think this is a good idea. Ooh, didn't do mix one of these either. Copy, paste. Is to somehow have a way where Atomic Nom can be sharing social hours with the other guys. And at the moment, he's not. They're completely out of kilter, so... Let's change these a little bit. But sleep there. Enjoy there. Enjoy there with the other guys. And I'll move this work a little bit earlier. And that way, Nom will at least socially relax with the other guys, even if he doesn't get to spend much time with them otherwise. Sorry about that. You're actually taking many of these down. And are they just sitting on the floor rotting once you have done so? Yeah, a bit. Oh no, Vadir does. People have been going up and grabbing them. Cool. Yes, so this is meaning that we are actually getting some meals coming back in again. These guys are doing good work getting that finished. Awesome. Mech is... Oh, right. I thought it was just chilling in there. I was like, you're not a prisoner anymore, dude. You are allowed out. It's okay. Now, was there any point in this structure? No. None whatsoever. What am I doing? Expand no roof area. Put that over the top there so they take that down. And then we can take the whole thing apart. Build complete make cowboy hat. We have sufficient cowboy hats. Not sure that anyone's using them, mind. Or maybe. Only one left in here, so surely someone's been putting these things on. Yep, cowboy hats for all. Except for Mick, who's got some sort of helmet. Rat self-tamed. No. Go away, Randy. So I'm going to continue thinking along the lines of security, giving these doorways just something protection-y. I can't think of a good way of properly defending a flat door like that. In reality, we need gun turrets and the like, don't we? We can go for that next, but you know, as soon as I click that, Randy's gonna be like, oh no you don't. No sir. Not happy with that one bit. Could put a sculptor's table down in here, continue our sort of crafting area, but it seems a little unnecessary. I don't actually want to do any of that yet. Last thing we need is statues this early in a colony's life. Rare Thrumbo, stop it! Every episode, the Thrumbos come to visit me. He's like, hello. You like Thrumbos, don't you? I heard you like Thrumbo, my man. Let me guess, something's going to happen, like Vadir is going to accidentally shoot one of them. You actually getting any... Vadir, Alicid even. You actually getting any good at this? Ish. That's not a nice place to be, is it? This is where the massacre happened. Vadir just wanders on through. Ah, be fine. Yo, Thrumbos. Might want to go and let them go and get those two. We'll be able to disassemble those later for something useful. Steel-wise, yeah! Research done. Okay, so do we go for the gun turrets, or do I... I need an advanced research bench for the medicine production, so maybe we do the gun turrets just on the basis that it's... I don't need to do anything else. Or do we do auto doors quickly? Speed everything up. Nah, it's got to be gun turrets, hasn't it? We've got to defend ourselves. There is no way I could live with doing anything else, and then Randy comes in with some massive tribesman pack in the next episode and ruins us. Or in this episode, even. God. Well, at least the food problem's sorted. That is plenty meat for the time being. Certainly long enough for our crops to start growing. I am going to move our crops from down around here. I don't think it's a particularly good place for them to be, in reality. What on earth? He wants to artificially inflate my colony value so that he's got an excuse to send nastier stuff. Usual Randy BS. So we're out completely of the sandstone. We do have limestone. I need to put someone on a higher priority with the stone cutting, don't I? Mick, you should probably craft instead of smithing or tailoring, I think is a safe one to do there. Isn't that not loud enough to wake you up? Getting repeatedly shot at. Okay, we got any other joists. We could put a billiards table down already. Make it out of wood, and yeah, we need cloth for that. Let's plant some cloth. Oh, there it is. Tribes people, prepare for a while, then attack. How many have we got? Quite a few. Although mostly melee. Only a couple of the cheaty pillars. Pillar, I should say. That's not a pillar. Don't say that. Not only will everyone be angry with you, but part of me wants to send Alicid over to just take some pot shots at them and really be a pain. I'm going to try that. I want to see what how they behave if you start messing with them outside of their range. Supposed to be preparing for a while, my friends. Okay, so what happens is they get angry enough that they all charge for him. No, they don't all charge for him. Some of them do. Not quite in range, no? This is a bit cheesy, I know. But, why not? Randy's cheesy. It's interesting, they sort of notice based on a proximity around where they're waiting rather than anything else. So it looks like you can kind of cheese this because they'll stop like that once they think they've defended their territory. Of course, despite all that training, Alistair still can't hit anything. This is probably not a very sensible way of doing this, but if I can possibly just wear one of them down, it would help. Just one. Just kill one. Just hit one. Any of the above would be fine. Come on. This is the problem with these sniper rifles early game, is your guys just can't hit anything with them. And they're so slow firing that it's almost... There we go. We've actually hit a dude once. Gunshot sniper rifle. Looks like it did hurt a fair bit, to be fair. Got to be ready for when these guys do decide that they're ready to attack and they just turn on Alistair all at once. Cheese it. Hit something. Nice. This is what we're talking about. Just whittle the numbers a little. Let's get back into position for them to want to defend their territory. Look, here they come. Territory defense. Shoot once. Move back. Soon as they sort of stop caring, you can turn around again. Nope, run, 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 run. They aren't attacking yet. They're just sort of being weird. They keep running past that dead body as well, which is pissing them off. That's got to be helpful. Want more sniper rifles? We did get a survival rifle, didn't we? Thinking about it. Yeah. Should have done the weapon switching. Okay, Radish, you've got a pistol when you could have a survival rifle. That's not a good idea. Who else have we got? Fadir pistol, again, could have something better. Fadir, go for the pump. Radish, go for the survival. Mick hasn't got anything. That's not very intelligent. Okay. Nom's fine, it's just Mick that's got nothing at all. You can go and grab a pistol from Vadir. Vadir, drop that stuff yet? Yep, go grab it. Oh, nice. Come on. Back. I'm being a bit too brave now with this. Oh, there it is. Okay, Vadir, you're gonna be... That doorway seemed to work really nicely for us last time. McGow, you have a shotgun. Let's get you over here. Nom, heavy SMG. Let's get you there, because I'm gonna assume they're gonna come the same direction as they did last time, pretty much. Vadir with the shotgun. Around this corner, perhaps? There's no real retreat from being around there, so I'm going to get you down in there. Radish with a survival rifle is another good long-range option. And that just leaves Mick with a pistol in the middle, maybe? We shall see! Alicid's going to need to get moving. These guys are going to want to actually be in the doorways to begin with, somewhere where they can shoot, and then we're going to move them in afterwards. That will make sense. Same with Mick in the doorway to begin with, then we move you out. Alistair can come in for the time being. Oh, no, it's Mick that's getting shot at. I was not expecting that. Can we brave another shot there? These two were the wrong way around. Alicid should have been back there. Radish should have been in here. 100%. That's enough shots for you, Miguel. Nice. That's enough shots for you, Nom. Faddy is ready to poke his head out. Radish is going exactly not the way I wanted him to, her to. But that's okay. And Mix probably in a position where he can poke his head a little bit. Give these guys some surprises as they come along. Back up. These guys with the snipers are going to have some fun. Miguel and Nom can probably think about pocking back out again. Who are you shooting at? Which one, I wonder? Oh, right. That's Worm that's going to get a surprise from Miguel and co. No one's been hit yet, but I'm really concerned because there's a bunch of our guys that are being shot at. Nice. Okay, Miguel, come out on the corner. Nom, come out. Get these guys in the back now. Alicid probably want to fall back after this shot, mate. Yep. Not actually inside. Radish can keep shooting for now. Gal's giving these guys fun in from behind. Someone got hit there. Alicid. Oh yeah, Alicid's getting melee'd. Damn it. Valier, get over here and be ready to defend him. Mick's doing alright. Miguel's doing alright. I don't think it's going to take very long now for them to flee. Critical alert, fire. Oh, you git! Get out of the meds! Okay, Alicid's alright there. You want to go over. They didn't actually make it in. That's too dangerous for Miguel now. Let's have a switch. Range on these heavy SMGs is not as much as I'd like, if I'm honest. That's better. Those guys are all getting the hell kicked out of them. Mick, you want to go inside, bro? Heatwave. Hey, Randy. You can come out. Nom's not really got a good hiding spot there. Anyone else that's been hit? No, it's just Alicid still. Don't know how. Alicid's about to get hit again at this rate. There we go. Nice. Get these two to go fire. Fire, fire, fire. Hey! That wasn't too bad. Just Alicid, who got a couple of bruises. Not bad. Right. Let's get all these into a position where they can be cleared up, please. There's a shotgun just out there in the middle of nowhere for some reason. These bodies are unforbid, but it seems a bit inconsistent. What's wrong? Wait, I can't speak English today. At all, apparently. Inconsistent. Yeah, good one, Wasted. Good one. God damn it. Ooh. Ibex Ram. What are you doing to that? Looking away. Give him the privacy. So, we got the heat wave. Gonna need to keep an eye out on people's health to make sure they don't lose it. However, we are not doing too badly. Oh, shearing. I didn't know you could. Fair enough. Suppose you can, can't you? Alpaca wool. Not alpaca wool in this case. Dromedary wool or whatever. Is it dromedary wool? Yeah. Camel hair. Makes sense. Don't normally mess around with animals like these folks. They're not just not really very relevant for what I'm normally doing. But the plan with this one is to actually get a load of caravans going and then eventually head for the sort of escape, the ending that involves us taking the caravan and going way out when. So, yeah. Still not so shabby. I don't really want to interrupt them at the moment. They've got plenty to be getting on with. I know what we can do. I can remove that floor that I keep trying to remove and then forgetting. And that one. And that one. And we can also Major break risk. Who's angry? McGow is really mad. What's up, McGow? Oh, it's just heatstroke. Needs... Friend died. Oh yeah, we still got the psychic drone as well, haven't we? Indoors is 41. Oh, damn. Did I continue to forget to put my cooler setup in? I don't want to put it there too much because the tribesmen keep coming, so it gets shot the hell out of. Let's just whack some sort of spotted about. So, is that one there? The idea with these is, while it looks like I'm going to have tons of them, they're, to some extent, going to actually increase the efficiency, because I don't necessarily have to have them all, like, set up in such a way that they're all running at the same temperatures. I can kind of stagger things, and therefore not have them all on unless it's absolutely necessary. However, I do need someone, preferably maybe you, Mick, to get that wood out of the doorway so we're not venting all the heat outside. That would be pretty nice. It's still blooming hot. It's still... Right, I think this is... Yeah, this is restrictions. Heat wave. Everybody inside. And then we find someone who isn't about to break. Like Vadir. And we force him... We need materials. What are we missing? We've got components. And we've got steel. So that's simply because he can't get at it. Fine. Fine, fine, fine. Vadir. Unrestricted. Still reckons we need materials. Three components. We got 46. And steel. We got 178. Ah, it just hadn't updated yet. Roger. Had to pause and unpause for it to actually update and do that. Right, let's get that. Bill ASAP. Still hot down there as well, but that should help for now. You can go back to heatwave restrictions. Actually, animals, so can you, please, so that you stop opening and closing the doors. And this is set to 21. That's set to 11? Really? I don't think we need it that cold in there. 21. 25. And they should start working together to bring the temp down. Even up in this one's not quite well insulated or cool enough, is it? Elephants. Hello. Better. Coming down a bit. Bedrooms are still pretty hot, though. Yeah, so I think it'll be a case of sending someone, maybe Nom or Radish, out. Heatstroke's serious, Mick. That's not good. But the drone's ending, so at least they probably won't... They'll stop breaking now. Nom, can you actually... You are restricted, and can you really just build that? See, the whole not assigned to constructing thing, even though... But it still lets me do it, which is quite cool. I do like the Zorba mods. Small things that they change, but very sort of just... easy life, peace of mind sort of stuff that just improves slightly the gameplay experience without necessarily making it any easier, you know? It just stops me from having to click through a bunch of extra menus. Back and forth we go. Really like you to finish that one. Thank you. And you can be set to say 30. Yep. Coming down. Not too bad. They're going to be idle as hell, of course, but more importantly, I need them to not have heatstroke. That's going okay. Cool, so let's temporarily, now everybody but Mick is healthy, let them all outside. Where's Mick? You, right. Go for it, guys. Very briefly, do work. It's gonna kill these plants, do you think? Cargo pods. with human meat. Nah, I'm not ready for that. Not ready for that. No, no, this is the Randy season, but not ready for that. Right, now let's go back to everybody inside. Also, the animals have to go outside to sleep, don't they? That's not a good idea. Furniture, sleeping spots. Does it matter for the time being? No. But I'm gonna hum and her about it anyway. That's the sort of thing I do. Get rid of these ones down here now as well. Cool. These deteriorating due to being unroofed. Okay, so I probably wanna actually have these as corpses. Mechanoid. Have those inside where possible. It's 51 even at night outside. That is pretty nasty. Poison one day. I'm gonna have to get another cooler on that somehow, aren't I? That's just not gonna be enough. I mean, it's quite a small fridge anyway, but that's just not gonna be enough. There is also the question, I suppose, of whether or not doing the floor actually adds any... It's granite, isn't it? Yep. Actually adds any, like, extra insulation to it. So I might give that a try in here, this little area, just to find out. I don't think it would, but... I don't know. Rimworld keeps getting all sorts of random mechanics added to it, which is cool as hell, but it means... Because I don't know if they actually give you information for, like, the walls and how... No, they don't. It doesn't say how insulating the walls act, but it does make a difference having two layers, so maybe the floors do. I don't know. Certainly helping making progress on research, this. Upset grown... Nothing fully ready yet. Just don't want to miss like a med harvest or something because it's heatwave territory. Okay, now, do I want to have another try at the clothing thing? Do we want to have another go at this? Interesting, do you see how that was on the mid still? Like it hadn't changed it last time. Weird. Okay, maybe there was something going on there then. I will probably allow the helmets as well. Armor vests are also okay. Personal shields and power armor are also okay. Okay, clear forced. I'm just going to try this with one person. We'll try it with... I mean, a lot of them are wearing what I want them to now anyway, to be fair. What's that? T-shirt, duster, pants, yeah. But a lot of them have got jackets on, which is not what I wanted. I want them to wear the dusters, which we probably need to make some more of, don't we? Are we done... No, we don't need to make more of, and you're making it out of absolutely anything we have. Yep, okay, good. Ignore that. Maybe they'll go and put it on then. It needs to be taken back to the stockpile before they'll wear it, though. No one's got particular heat problems at the moment, do they? Everyone is healthy except Mick, who has got heatstroke initial because of what he's wearing. So... I'm not 100% sure what's going on there. Mick. There we go. And then if I clear the forest, he won't just take him off or anything. But yeah, that's behaving really kind of odd. But I reckon that'll almost certainly be why he was, yeah, his heat stroke's now gone, because he's not wrapped up in armor, getting super hot inside. Cool, guys. Go, be free. Briefly. Don't accidentally hit an elephant. You're gonna accidentally hit an elephant. That meat is not that important. No, do something else. half of this is they just needed materials from the other place, and that's one problem with having our stockpile separate, isn't it? That's why it's not a good idea, is we're going to spend so much time cooped up inside the base in this season that I can't do that. In which case, we should probably start making use of some of the area that we know we won't be using. How's the heatstroke? Heatstroke watch! Alright for time being. That's actually quite cold outside. For whatever reason. Oh, there you go. That's why it's quite cold outside, because the heatwave's finishing. Roger that. So yeah, where do I want to put this stockpile zone? Because it's just crap down there. I might make it into somewhere we could grow stuff, because it's all nice soil, by the looks of things. Yep, lots of soil in there. So yeah, we'll grow in there. We'll make that into a greenhouse. Where do I put the refresh one? It needs to be a stockpile, might as well be on something that we can't grow on. So it could have been there. Same way it could also be, I could like extend down here. But that does break up what's so far been quite a nice little fire zone for when things start attacking. Won't be having geothermal power for bloody ages, so where are we? I could get it a bit sooner than I thought, but still. And let's let the animals outside as well before they starve, shall we? I guess it kind of has to be on here somehow. Because I don't want to get too close to the edge there. I could go a bit further here. I'll do it over this rock. That makes sense. That makes sense. We can have it sort of this area where we won't be able to actually grow anyway. Let's mine some of this stuff out here then. Sort of the end of the corridor system. Let's get rid of that rubbish too. It's kind of annoying. Yeah, I think that should work. Nice, proper food coming in as well. We could probably start thinking about upping our meal quality for a little bit as well. Yeah, let's cook a fine meal, details, minimum cooking skill of 10. Use whatever you like as long as it's not human meat. Insect meat is not acceptable as well, apparently. Radius, as before. And until we have ten. And of course it's second in the list. Yeah, that makes sense. And then as soon as we've got a decent stockpile of the basics, we can then move on to something a little bit more rewarding for our folks, because they'll probably like that. Everyone's quite angry with me at the time being, as you'd expect. Yeah, so I'm thinking here we could, first of all, think about maybe building this wall out of stone. Except we're running out. That won't do forever. Need to give someone else more of a crafting priority, don't we? Yeah, I'm going to bring Vadir off some duties and get him. Visitors from Discord are leaving. Hey, look, these guys are turning up quite often. None of the actual folks from Discord mind. That colony does kind of exist and have people in it. So yes, we will hopefully be having encounters with a few people we recognise over the length of this series. I thought that might be kind of fun just for the sake of it. Alicid, you are not still forced, are you? No. So that's more from the case that... What gear is it that's... Shit. Your jacket? Just get rid of it then. I don't want you to wear a hyperweave jacket anyway. I want you to wear a duster. Anyway, that's dug out a bit, so wall, still have the stone problem. What do we do, go limestone on the basis that we're making more of that and these chairs are almost done? Or do I just go steel for the time being on the basis that we will replace it? It's going to have to be steel on the basis we will replace it, and we don't really have enough to do anything else. So yeah, I'm thinking we don't want to use up too much growing air at the end here. We also want to think about obviously leaving space here for another sort of corridory bit like this. Constant ways in and out is what I'm thinking. That's also not quite what I was thinking. I don't want to expand this down as well, so these corridors, so have it come down another step the same size, you know. So that's fine, that's where that door would be, and then, I mean, for now, we might as well just seal off this end, and... Oh, geothermal. Which will want to be outside, so... That's fine, that means we can have some sort of little... Play. I keep pausing it for this stuff. It means we can have some sort of little outside area there, maybe. That they have to walk through. Let's leave two squares from the edge, so... I'm actually going to leave three so they can walk around the geo as well. And then doors will be... There and there. Once this is built, we can cut this apart and... That wasn't sensibly done. That wall seems a bit pointless at this point. It made sense for the separation that was there, but in reality, if this is just going to be a big stockpile room, then leave it. Everything very quiet. Power looking all right. That's one thing I've got to keep an eye on as we keep expanding this stuff. Make sure power's still okay. Okay, wood's all right. Cut plants. Let's just get rid of the trash that's blocking these doorways as well. Get out of it. Get out of it. Those ones are kind of all right. And is there anything growing? Yep. Chocolata is pregnant. Pregnant? English. English wasted. Do you speak it? No. Did I let the animals outside? I think I did. The elephants look unconvinced by what I'm doing here. Almost trapped one inside. Could have been fun. Cool. So, copy settings. Orders. Where's our stockpile? The adding parthing at the top of that is really confusing me. Just every time. I know it's crap, but... So, there and there. Yeah, that's right, guys. I'm going to make you move all this stuff again. Do we want to put the chair and tables in this area? Screw it. Let's copy the trading spot up there and let's reinstall and have our chair and tables with it. They can all, everyone can just come and be up here. That makes sense. Probably an easier and more sensible way of doing this, but screw that. So this, I can almost plant over the entire interior, might even expand it a bit, keep the roof, and then use it as like a temperature-controlled growing area where I can get maximum efficiency. Because I'm pretty sure this stuff is all growing at like 20% reduced efficiency because of how I've got things set up. Around that, minor break risk, Vadir. Still no one. No. I take it back. I think what we might want to do is actually have two stonecutters tables. Honestly. Give them more opportunity to work with it. That's the central point of the room? Yeah. I do have a plan there. It will make more sense as it builds out. Should I be nice and start giving these guys stools? We've run out of wood. Again, that's fine. I really wanted to, as mentioned, start clearing as much of the cover that we've left kicking around here as possible. Don't want to give these guys anywhere to hide. Actually, not that much wood. I have done a fair bit of it by those things. How's our trees going? Whoa! Cutting our first of our own wood. The old homegrown. Cleaning's looking a bit lackluster. Nice, this can... It's a shame there's no way of copying the build from one table to another. That'd be quite nice. Build copy, I suppose, would have done it, wouldn't it? Doll. Make any stone blocks forever. Yeah. What I should probably do with that is make sure that the ingredient radius isn't ridiculous. There you go. Well, that way, if need be, we can have two together. Working on that. McGow! You are bored with nothing to do. Go craft. All that out. Get some lights in there. There's no power. Get some power over there. That's a relatively easy run across. That's a bit inefficient, but whatever. That's what we're doing. Lamp. Visitors again. Visitors from the crew. Sammy and Sio. Yeah, it looks like they don't actually send the colonists from the colony. They make up people to go, but it just says they come from the... That's a bit of a shame. Maybe if we visit the colony, we then get to see who's there. I think you can probably guess who's at that one. And this is going to want venting through. I am going to leave it still doored off, though, on the basis that it's going to be pretty ugly in there. I'll probably put a cooler this end of the system. And avoid... Yeah, avoid the geothermal. Half-decent meals, food supplies are kind of semi-okay. This stuff's all getting cleared out. Misc furniture, yep. Sun lamp, how do they fit in here? Pretty well. Does that be overlap? Yeah, not badly. Of course, I don't need to... That's the end I want the least, so you'd probably do it something like one there. And one... there. It's hard to picture the coverage without them being built. And then turn this area into just one big temperature-controlled growing area. There you go, so... God damn it. Really? While I'm watching it. So there's a line of crossover there, but that's fine because all it's really doing is avoiding going too far this direction, but completely utilising this side apart from these tiny little corners. And in here, we can grow a mix of stuff once they're finished putting out the fires. Handy little mod, that one as well. No one gonna go and haul all that meds. That's so much things to haul. That's the problem, isn't it? Because I just told them to move our entire supplies up to there as well. Yeah, they're getting on it. They're getting on it. I just won't interrupt. Finish up, folks. Mix found himself a duster. Good man. Oh, we hit, yeah, with the, I mean, whoops. Mistakes. We are hitting power concerns, and... Oh, this is when there's been no wind. Okay, that's at least something. I am going to temporarily boost things with the solar panel. Not sure I'm going to put it down there, because they keep burning things that I put down there. Oh yeah, we can put these in front of the power themselves, can't we? Forgetting about that. Not perfect, but unfortunately, we seem to have designed them to not be perfect. There we go. We do just about have enough power once the wind generators are all generating, but... Yeah, right. So this is all very pointless without an actual growing zone in there. One absolutely bloody enormous growing zone. Sure, why not? In which we shall grow. Smoke leaf, no. Rice, potatoes, corn. It's that big question from last season. I'm just going to stick with my potatoes for the time being. One herbal meds and prioritize hauling the meds, guys. I was about to say, hopefully they actually pick it all up as well as part of that. I don't want to lose all the meds. Now we've got meds. I know they're not massively helpful, but it's better than nothing. Before you go to bed, get rid of that. Thank you. Yes, leave it in the doorway. What a great idea. I suppose it was probably my fault. I did tell you to, but anyway. Already hauling, okay. It's one more option than I was expecting to see. What? So we got a spare shotty. Someone's still got a pistol, haven't they? I think it's Mick. Yeah, Mick's still got a pistol. So you can get yourself a shotgun. Nice. Where's he put it? There it is. Probably a terrible shotgun. Yep. But a shotgun it is. So this is not good for the temperature, because obviously we're having power issues. Squirrel self-tame. Stop making me slaughter animals, Randy. I don't want them. I just don't want a squirrel. There is no point to it. The colony's squirrel... No, no. These guys getting trained? Why have I still not gone around to do that? Idiot. Thank you, Mick. Go back. Pump shotgun. Good man. Oh, I feel like I'm coming up to the end of the episode time, and Randy has been incredibly quiet this episode. I don't know what he's doing, but far too quiet for my comfort. How's this stuff? 70, 40. Alas, turn off sewing on... Whoop, I didn't mean to double-click all of it. Yes. Why is that? I just want this one. Thank you. Don't want to replant these ones that are outside now. And what I should really have done is kept, like, a corner of this for heal root. So... That area should be... Where's it gone? Heal root. There we go. That way we can start moving some of this stuff completely indoors. Spot on. Where, if nothing else, it'd be in a nice, as I said, temperature protected area. This stuff's growth rate 100% at the moment. Maybe I didn't need to do it, but... I don't know. We'll see. These can be uninstalled as well. There's two sun lamps in that room. I don't think we need extra lighting. Worst case scenario, I can always just remove the roof. Get rid of the lights, remove the roof. Does have the advantage, I suppose, of providing all-day light. But the plant still rests, so it doesn't necessarily make much difference. visiting grave. Everyone's just chill. So chill. Oh, damn, son. Turrets are done, but that means turrets are done. Let's go for... Fighting's tempting. But not super tempting. Auto doors is kind of really useful to speed up how rubbish everybody is. And then you've got medicine production, for which I need to upgrade the research bench. And then we've got tube television. So I'm going to start off with auto doors. And we can immediately think, what are we going to do protection-wise? Where are these guys going to go? It's quite nice about sort of tucking something around the corner so that they have to come in to its view in order to deal with it properly. So I might whack one there, and on the basis that it's really annoying when they outrange it. One round the corner down here? No, it's not really worthwhile, is it? Alright, for now, let's just have one there. We will eventually work on creating our usual death trap to the base, but at the moment, not really viable. And these lights can go somewhere else, because I'm going to need to make the research bench bigger, and I think the advanced one's two squares longer, isn't it? Quickly check, production, high tech. Yeah, it's two blocks longer. So it does fit there, but one of those lights would have to go away. Fits there really badly, in fact. I might put that there and get rid of this. 10 components, we have got that. And I need to do some mining. Is this the plasteel? Yep. That's the plasteel. Down here we got a little bit left. Clearly not going to be much more than that. Where was our next target? I've already been down there for the components. I remember there being golden components at the far end, but also... What is it? Something stirs. Whatever rubbish it says. That's jade, I think. Yep. We're already pretty much out of any sort of mineable stuff on this side of the map, with the exception of that. What I could also do is strip the random bit of floor that's just sitting there. Anything else like that about, I can just quickly get rid of. There were some fateful... Every time I just try and deconstruct these walls, Randy does something. So we'll see. Maybe that is the trigger. Not allowed to take down his walls on the map, otherwise he gets pissed. Tatadaparal. Still Alicid. I suppose we don't have another duster for you to wear at the moment, do we? I don't think. Which immediately makes me look at this and go, oh yes, I need to start categorising our storage system some point real soon. Maybe something for the next episode, or even something I do in between, because honestly, watching me fiddle around with zones while nothing happens, and I can do it obviously completely paused, is not very interesting. So I might jump ahead and do that for the next episode. Otherwise, I am going to call it here. Randy's not done anything, but at least we've made a bit of progress. Especially with the research. Got gun turrets ready. Auto doors soon. Started to expand this out. Built our new... Well, I mean, this should be a very nice area for anything, really. These light level 50%, so that these ones right in the corners might not ever grow. Maybe. We'll see. Might have to do something to help them out. Like... Put a little... Do the normal lights work? Don't know. We'll find out. There you go, guys. Hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, please hit that like button. Please hit subscribe if you haven't already. Really helps me and the channel out. If you didn't like it, slam away on that dislike button. That actually helps me out as well. So either way is good. And otherwise, I'll catch you guys for the next one. Raid. Nope.